what we have seen is a big outflows from European equity markets. So that's clear that we have seen a strong risk aversion against European equities. That is something we can record in our data. It's the worst data we have seen in February, March, when you look since we got the data in 2000. So there is a lot of pessimism on the European equity market right now. On our side, we revised down also the GDP growth from 4% to 3%. We revised up the inflation outlook. We cut our EPS growth for this year from 8% to 2%. However, we don't share the very gloomy outlook for Europe overall. And we think that there is in the market some pocket that is very attractive right now in Europe.
And I was looking at some of your research on the discount now that Europe is trading on, and we have certainly seen some pockets of weakness around key markets that were favourites for a lot of investors a few months back, the likes of Germany and France. But, you know, in the headlines today, whether we're seeing gas supply cut off from Russia, we've already seen the German blueprint on rationing supply, and we know how detrimental that could be to major manufacturing. Are we looking at a region that is now cheap for a reason?
Well, I don't think that the investor that leave European equity market a few weeks back will come back without a better visibility on the geopolitical situation, right? So we still have, you know, risk on, risk off days, and we continue to see high volatility in the coming days. However, if we have any visibility, better visibility on the situation, those investors will come back. And as you mentioned, the valuation is very appealing. Let me give you a number. We are now trading with more than 30% discount on European equities versus the US. I mean, this is an all-time high in terms of discount. And what is amazing is that if you look at each sector in Europe, except pharmaceuticals, you are trading with a heavy discount on European equities sector versus US peers. So I'm trying just to explain that right now the market has already factoring a lot of bad news and probably, you know, more than what is already expected by most of the consensus economists. And the market have probably overreacted. And again, as I say, in some particular pocket of the market.
Yeah, but Roland, that underperformance has been there for some time. And I think at this stage, there are a lot of people that are asking themselves, does Europe look like a value trap if we end up with recessionary-like conditions by the end of the year?
Sure, of course, if we talk about stagflation, if we talk about recession. But, you know, we need to factor in also the fiscal policy that has been put in place at European level. So we think that at least 2% of GDP to support household against this energy crisis, to support corporate against this energy price increase. And also keep in mind that the situation, we started also from a very robust situation, if I may so, because we got very, very low unemployment rate, right? And we got very high saving, excess saving. We talk about 360 billion euro on deposit excess saving. So I think it's important to take all this into account. The situation of the job market, the excess saving, but also the fiscal policy, which is clearly at work to, let's say, a way to reduce the impact of this strong inflation. And I don't think that this is really factored in by the investor right now.
Hi, I'm Giovanna Bersecchi, and thank you for watching. You can check out more of our videos by clicking on the boxes on the screen. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more from CNBC International. Thank you for watching.